Wolf190D here with another battle. So, for those of you that are returning, welcome back. We have an engagement that we may have been looking for. Let's find out. It's another design of battleship that appears to be a lot better than what I've run into in the past. So, let me go ahead and get my fleets in order. Get my destroyers out and doing what I would like them to do. Heavy cruisers are setting a screen. You know what? I'll leave them on a screen, but I think what I'm going to do with my light cruisers here, set them to follow. And then I can break them off and do things with them as the battle progresses. So let's go ahead and zip on ahead. Yes, go find those enemy ships. I'm getting close to the RDF tech, and then I'll be able to show you what that actually looks like. This retreat thing kind of gets annoying after a while because it's really difficult to just set the battle speed on fast and get to the action. Alright, uh-oh. They've got some lights on me. My battleships were already lit. Okay, there they are. Oh. Let's not waste our torpedoes on the little guys. We want to save our torpedoes for the big ships. And what are you doing? I want you... There we go. Okay. Now... it's still twin tubes. So these are the first build that I did with Destroyer 1s. Once again, we've already seen them in action. But as you can see, the battleships are opening up at long range. And this is where you can kind of have a lot of fun, actually. Just shooting into the masses. Okay. Oh, boy. These battles are rather entertaining when you get into the ones where you have, like... You have one ship, and they have, or not one ship, but you have, you're outnumbered. I do notice that it tends to become a lot to keep track of if you have 100 ships. So, smaller task forces, and the way I did this battle was, is I had a task force out of the ocean. Basically, I intercepted an enemy fleet. So we have I think these are gonna be Nuremberg class ships. So I'm gonna go ahead and break these guys off and let them get into the fight. Now this is something the AI is notorious for. They they do that a lot. You'd be surprised. And that appears to be his battleship back there. It looked a lot better than the other ones that I've been running up against. Oh, no, 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 wrong way, wrong way. Oh, boy. And that's why I turn off the collision avoidance, because his destroyer was close. It interfered with what I was trying to do maneuver-wise. So that's why I turn off the collision avoidance system, because it's kind of a joke. Okay. And now my destroyer's been a little messed up. So, let's see here. Let's fire off into the crowd with the secondaries. Oh my goodness. The volume of firepower that comes out of the battleship sometimes is rather impressive. Let's just start putting some rounds into the middle of this formation somewhere. How about focus on the bush? And there we go. So see, you just see racking up hit after hit after hit on those. Okay, be careful with these light cruisers because they might try to run off in here and get in trouble. And some battleship projectiles just went into the middle of that formation. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and shoot some torps because I have big guns now in this fight, and I might be able to do a little something against his battleships. Oh, good grief, this destroyer is in trouble. He might be in a lot of trouble. He might be. And again, he might save himself. And really, yeah, be very, very aware of when you run ships up into the middle of combat like that, because friendly fire is a thing. So keep that in mind. I've absolutely wrecked my own ships before. Uh-oh. And this is where the auxiliary engine comes in handy, is when your destroyer's engines start to become affected. I gotta get him out of there. He's in trouble. He is in trouble. Okay. Light cruisers come about. What happened? Where's my... Yeah, okay. This guy... I'm gonna go ahead and detach him. And you get out of dodge. If you can. I don't know that he's gonna make it. Alright, did he fix his steering yet? No. I'm going to drop his speed a little bit so he doesn't get too far out of the fight, but I'm going to leave him alone for now. The hipper looks like it's probably about toast. So, yeah, you, come on. And it's really one of the annoying things where ships that are in divisions, they'll only go as fast as the slowest ship in the division, so you kind of have to pay attention to that too. All right, so this is getting to be really intense, actually. Now, which one of these? Ah, the Friedrich Wilhelm is one of my was my first dreadnought build, so. That guy is getting to be a little dated. I think what I'm going to try to do, though, if it'll let me do it. No. Hagen. I'm going to go ahead and detach these guys into their own little battle squadron. Okay, so. Kurfürst Friedrich Wilhelm. Uh-huh. I'm going to back them guys out. All right. And we're going to split up divisions and see if we can't do something about dividing them up a little bit better. No, the hipper's still a lot. Good grief. That's a tough little bugger, isn't it? He's fixing to get swarmed, though, is the big problem here. Yeah, that's going to be a problem. And you can just kind of see where that's beginning to hurt a little bit. What do we do? Take a torpedo hit. Yep. Didn't do much damage, but it's a torpedo hit. He repaired his steering gear yet? No. Uh-huh. And there, you know, it's really battleships. You have to protect the battleships. And I'm not doing a good job of that right now. I'm really not doing a good job of that right now. I'm getting in tight to these. I'm letting these destroyers get in close, and they're just going to start to cause all kinds of problems for me. So let's go ahead and reset. Let you guys auto aim on who you're going to aim on. Hopefully I can get the Hipper out of there. Okay. And just an example, there again, you know, be really, really cautious about doing things like this specifically, because, no, I don't want the main guns on him. I want secondaries on him. The main guns I want somewhere else. I'll tell you what, you guys just do what you're going to do for now and do what you're going to do for now. The auto aim feature doesn't do a terrible job of target selection, but just be aware if you want more of a manual experience with it. There we go. All right, we eliminated those two destroyers that were starting to harass my battleships. The Bavaria, what is the Bavaria doing here? Okay, we're gonna set you back over here, and my light cruisers, I'm gonna run you guys around. Okay, so back in the fight. I'll go ahead and pop smoke on this destroyer. Where is his battleship? Does anybody else remember that board game? I want to sink his battleship. Alright, shift click does manually target for torpedoes. Not that I want to do that right now, actually. Yeah, actually I don't want to do that. This might be potentially upsetting. I don't like running battleships up into light cruiser formations like this. Torpedoes are not your friend in a battleship. Okay, so the Bavaria, she's holding her own right now. Let me get a good shot here of those secondary guns just going to work, hopefully. Yes, yes. Okay. And the Bavaria actually is one of my Irene heavy cruisers. I'm really limiting early game. I tend to limit at least Germany's heavy cruisers because their designs are just god awful. And there's a good example of why to shoot for center of mass. All of that damage going into that light cruiser formation there. And they've got them pretty well clustered up too. So nice easy targets. That good fiery explosion, that was torpedoes going off. So yeah, aim for center mass if you can. Oh my goodness. I'm neglecting my light cruisers. And they might be running up into some trouble here. these battleships could very well be running off into some trouble too, though. These are my big battleships. Let's put the main guns on the heavy cruiser. These the secondaries on these guys are probably more than sufficient for those light cruisers. 6-inch guns tend to do really well against the light cruisers, at least so far. Who was I trying to pay attention to? Okay. You'll notice the top speed on that destroyer is down to 26 knots. I'll have to be really, really careful with him. And he fired off a torpedo, but I had already started to turn. Okay, there goes that. All right. Boom. Gotcha. Has he fired off his torpedoes yet? No, not yet. Okay, got to the destroyer before he could unload more torpedoes. And again, this is just where you have to practice situational awareness. I mean, good grief. I'm trying to use that destroyer. Give chase to his battleship, but so far he's not letting me. The enemy destroyers are doing a good job of screening for the larger ships. Me, on the other hand, I'm just kind of trying to jump all over the place and keep my battleships from completely being obliterated. And all of my other ships, for that matter. That's something to bear in mind is if you progress through these things, is especially when you're outnumbered like this, you really have to be careful about taking losses. Oh my. It looks like he sank both of them. Woohoo! All right. It looks like it's about time for cleanup, so I don't I'm not gonna be able to run him down. That's not gonna happen. But this destroyer. All right, so now we get a good look at what he's got here. So not a bad build actually. 13-inch main guns. Honestly, this looks like something. No, it's not something I set up for him because the battleship I built as a shared design had these wire towers. So this is not one of the. This is older tech, but still, he's got 13-inch Mark IIs. So. Shells still aren't doing what we want them to do, but this V-49. I'm gonna go ahead and get him out of here because he's pretty well banged up. The Medusas or the light cruisers, I'm going to set on an intercept course. for these battleships. And again, this one's got a like my earliest dreadnought design. So three twin 11-inch guns, not terribly obsolete, but I have much better ships that I have access to now, so I've actually started phasing them out. And I do believe I built something like that's why he's not running him down as well as I'd like, because I don't have his speed maxed out. So 35 not top speed, but because of structural damage and flooding and things, it does actually slow your ships down. So if your ships take heavy damage, don't expect them to run very fast anymore. All right, so let's see here. We're still sort of behind. Hopefully I can get on him before those big guns reload. There we go. And this poor guy. Oh, he sank before I could torpedo him. Well, that's the end of that one. German fleet making a really good showing. And again, it's a great example of tech levels. So I had three of the Tirpitz class battleships. They're pretty solid. And this was the Westfalen. It was my first dreadnought design. I built it on a small dreadnought hull before I had the ability to mount two superimposed guns. So, anyway, that's that battle. As always, thanks for watching. And if you like the content, please like, subscribe. And incidentally, also, hey, for those of you out there that run this game, you have a better way of doing things, tips, tricks, etc., feel free to leave some comments as well. So, that is the stats, and thank you for stopping by once again.